Assalamu alaikum dear students, I am Yamin Khan Jamali, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Ustad Bukhari, Government Dairy College, Dadu. Dear students, today we are starting chapter number 8 of class 12. The name of the chapter is Variation and Genetics. This chapter number 8 that has its own terminology. We have to study and understand this terminology. Without this terminology, we are not able to understand this chapter. So it is very necessary that we must understand the terms involved. Number one is source, hybridization. Hybridization. Hybridization is a common term used in this chapter. Hybridization means cross between, cross meaning reproductive process, cross between two individuals of the same species of different sexes, suppose male and female. Cross between two individuals of the same species which differ in some characters. This is a hybridization. Suppose we allow to cross between tall male pea plant with short female pea plant. This is a hybridization. Or suppose we allow to cross mice, one is tall and other one is short in stature, or one is black in color, other one is white in color. This cross between two individuals of the different sexes of the same species, this is hybridization. And a hybrid or filial generation. The offspring that we obtained from the cross, this is a hybrid or a filial generation. Suppose we allow the cross between black and white mice, the offspring that we will receive, that offspring obtained from this cross is called hybrid or filial generation. Number three is mono hybrid cross or single trait inheritance. Mono mana one, mono or single, that meaning one. Mono hybrid cross meaning a cross between two individuals which differ only in one character. This is a mono hybrid cross. Suppose there are pea plants, one is tall and other one is short. This is a mono hybrid cross. Or suppose the plant, suppose male plant that is red flower colored and other one is a white flower colored. This is called a monohybrid cross. Dear students, if the individuals crossed, they differ in many characters, but we study only one character, this is also called a monohybrid cross. And if they differ in two characters, this is dihybrid cross or inheritance of two traits, inheritance of two traits or dihybrid cross. The cross between two individuals of the same species which differ in two characters, this is a dihybrid cross. Suppose the cross between tall pea plant and short pea plant, they also differ in other character. Suppose the tall pea plant, it is having seed yellow seed color, and the short pea plant that having green seed color, this is a dihybrid cross or inheritance of two traits. Or suppose there is a couple, that couple, out of that couple, one male is tall with black eye color, and the female that is a short in stature with a blue eye color, meaning they differ in two characters. This is dihybrid cross or inheritance of two characters. The individuals allowed to cross, they differ in three characters, that will be called a trihybrid cross. If they differ in four characters, tetrahybrid cross, and so on. The term dominant gene, dominant gene. Dominant gene meaning gene that shows its character or expresses its characters, or a gene that explains its character in the offspring, that is a dominant gene. Suppose a couple having, the male having black eye color and the female that having a blue eye color, the baby, first baby that having black eye color, that meaning the gene for black eye color that has expressed its character, this is a dominant gene. The hybrid obtained, that is denoted by B capital, B symbol. Symbol here, B capital is for black eye color and B symbol is for blue eye color, and here the baby that having a black eye color, the gene for black eye color received from his father, that is a dominant, and the gene obtained from the mother that has not expressed its character, this is a, that meaning black eye color that has expressed its character, that is a dominant gene. And the dominant characters, dear students, dominant characters are always denoted by capital letters, and the characters fail to express their characters, the recessive, they are denoted by small letters. And number 6 is recessive gene. Dear students, the gene that failed to express its character, cannot explain its character, that is a recessive gene. Suppose we take an other example. Suppose there is a couple that having, one having, the male having tall and the female that is short in stature. Or we take an other example. Suppose we allow to cross the between pea plants. One pea plant, suppose male is tall and the female plant, pea plant, is short, and offspring obtained, the new plants obtained, they will be denoted as, and we will obtain tall pea plant. Suppose there is a cross between tall pea plant and short pea plant, we will obtain all the tall. Here the gene that is denoted by T capital, that is a dominant, but the gene for short or dwarf color that has not expressed its character, that will be called a recessive gene. And we know recessive characters, they are denoted by small letters. The just like we have denoted short character with a T small and a blue eye color with a B small. Number 7 is phenotype. Phenotype. Dear students, the character, the physical character is called phenotype, or visible character is called phenotype. Phenotype meaning the physical appearance of an individual is called phenotype. Physical appearance. Suppose the physical appearance of a man just like me, that is suppose a short one, that is shortness is the phenotype character. Or suppose me a tall man, that is also a phenotype character. Or suppose I have black eye color or brown eye color, this is visible character, can be seen by others. That phenotype visible character is called phenotype character. Skin color is also a phenotype character. Suppose a man that is mentally retarded, this mental character, that is also a phenotype, because we will observe it by his actions. So the characters which are visible or which can be observed, which can be seen, these characters are called phenotype. And those invisible characters, they are the genotype. Genotype are the characters, genotypes, the genetic makeup or genetic constitution is called a genotype. For your understanding, we can say that genotype is the invisible. Just like phenotype is a visible character, genotype invisible character. Wild type, that meaning commonly occurring phenotype characters among the members of a species. We take an example, suppose of the sheep. We know, dear students, sheep, we know they have white hair color, they have brown color, and some of the sheep they have black hair color. But here in Pakistan and in Sindh, the white hair color of the sheep, that is a common character, commonly occurring, that is wild type character. Wild type meaning the commonly occurring phenotype character is wild type. Just like I have given you the example of the sheep. Sheep have three hair color, but here in Pakistan, the white fur color is the common. The members of such character, they are great in number. So the white color sheep, that is a wild type. I give you another example. Here in Pakistan, buffaloes, they have two colors, the black skin color and the brown. And which character is common in the buffaloes? That is black. So black skin color in the buffaloes, that is a wild type character. Understand? Okay. Alleles. What are the alleles? Alleles, a pair of genes with contrasting characters. Pair of the genes having the contrasting characters. Or we can say that the genes, the alternative form of the same gene. Same gene here meaning, same gene meaning the genes for same trait. Let us see the example here. Suppose B capital and B small. This B capital, B small, these both letters, they denote eye color here. B capital is for black eye color, B small is for blue eye color. This is alternative form of the same gene. Same gene, that meaning direction, same gene meaning the same character. The genes for same character are alternative form of the same gene. Alternative are the genes having a contrasting character. This is black eye color, the gene for blue eye color, or another example, this is tall, gene for tall color, and this gene is for short. This is for tallness and this denotes for shortness. This is alternative form, or a pair of the genes having contrasting different characters, that is alleles. Clear beta? And in the and locus means position of the gene on a chromosome. Suppose pair of a chromosome, these are the genes. Suppose this is gene for black eye color and this gene is for blue eye color, or this gene is for tallness and this gene is for shortness. The gene for black eye color and this is for blue eye color, the position of the gene on chromosome, the position of a gene, that meaning where a gene is present, where a gene is located, locus meaning position of the genes, or where a gene is located on, where a gene is located on homolog pair of the chromosomes, this is called position, that meaning the locus. And alleles always lie, these are the alleles to one another, B capital and B small, these are the alleles to one another. And we know alleles always lie in the same position, that meaning they lie on a different chromosome but on the same position. Here gene B capital, that is at the first position, here it's allele. The B small, that also lies at the same position, number 1. So alleles always lie at the same locus or same position. Dear students, homozygous, homo meaning the same, and zygous mean for zygote. If a zygote that receives both the homo meaning the same genes for any character, and you know the each character, every character that has at least two genes. Suppose for tallness there are two genes in each and every individual, either animal or a plant. Homozygous meaning genes, a zygote that receives same genes. Suppose, and the zygote we know is formed by the fusion of two gametes. Zygote is formed by the union of two gametes. Suppose one is female gamete, the ovum, and other one is sperm, the male gamete. When they get each difference, each gamete, either ovum or sperm, they have only one gene for that specific particular character. And when they fuse with each other to form the zygote, and if this zygote that receives both the same similar genes for any character, that is homozygous. Suppose for tallness, the zygote that receives gene for tallness gene from the mother through the ovum, and tall gene, also tall gene from father through a sperm. Here the zygote received both the same or similar genes. This is a homozygous. Or suppose that zygote receives gene for shortness from his mother through ovum, and also receives gene for shortness from his father through sperm. Here the zygote has received both the similar genes for any character. This is homozygous. Or suppose this is zygote from which an individual that will be produced, we know, it receives eye color, black eye color from mother, and also black eye color from father. This is also homozygous. Dear friends, heterozygous. Hetero meaning different. Suppose if a zygote that receives, suppose this is ovum and this is sperm, they fuse to form the zygote. And if the zygote, and dear students, we know zygote will develop to form an individual. We also started our lives from the single cell, the zygote. If this is zygote that receives both the different genes, suppose for eye color, the zygote has received black eye color gene from mother through ovum, and blue eye color gene from father through sperm. It means the zygote has received both the dissimilar genes. Both the dissimilar genes. One is for black eye color from the mother, and other one be similar, that is for blue eye color. The zygote has received both the different genes for this trait, for this character. Or suppose another example. Suppose this zygote that has received gene for tallness from his mother, and the gene for shortness from his father, that meaning this zygote has received both the dissimilar genes. One gene for tallness from the mother, and one gene the for shortness from father, that meaning the zygote has received both the dissimilar genes. Or for this character, both the dissimilar genes. This is called heterozygous, dear students. So that was all about for the terms which are commonly used in this chapter of the genetics. Dear students, I hope that you have gained some points from these terms, and If you have understood all these terms, so it will be very easy for you that you will understand the further genetics laws that will be discussed in our next lecture. Thank you very much, dear sir.